gosh, I'm so stupid. Once again, I don't understand what anyone is saying. Welcome to The Art of Speaking Up, a podcast that empowers professional women to rise. I'm your host, Jessica Guzik. And in this show, I take you undercover into the stories and lessons that I learned, sometimes the hard way, throughout my career. I also talk with working women, leaders, and coaches to show you that no matter what your struggle is, and no matter what your career goals are, you already have all the talent that you need to succeed. Welcome to the show. I am back with another bonus episode. I get very excited when recording these. I think it's because the word bonus makes me really excited. It's an exciting word. I don't know. I'm strange. But I wanted to talk today about something that I think can sometimes hold us back. And I know it's something that really held me back for a while, and I didn't even really realize it. And so I wanted to share some of what I've learned with you in case it might help you feel better about yourself and feel more confident in certain situations. And the thing that I'm talking about today is that feeling that you get when you're maybe sitting in a meeting, or maybe even you're having an informal conversation at work about something that everybody is working on. And you hear the people around you talking, and they're going back and forth, and they're talking about something, and you realize that you don't really understand what they're saying. You're listening to what they're saying, and you're like, you're trying to grasp onto it. Like, you're trying in the moment to be like, okay, like, maybe it'll make sense if I listen to the next thing they say and the next thing they say. And after a while, you're just like, nope, I'm lost. I have no idea what they're saying. I am completely confused, and I don't know what to do. And that feeling doesn't feel very good, because first of all, I think the feeling of confusion is very deeply uncomfortable. It's disorienting by nature, right? Because it's confusing. And so I think it's kind of like a little bit like getting off of a merry-go-round or being really, really dizzy when you're like, okay, I know that I shouldn't feel dizzy because I'm not on it anymore, but I still feel like everything's spinning. I feel like when people are talking and you can't follow the thread, or you think you can't follow the thread, which I'll clarify more on that in a minute, then you kind of get into this space of like being very disoriented and thinking it should make sense. And it kind of knocks you off both intellectually, and this brings me to the second part, it also kind of knocks you off your feet from an emotional standpoint and from a self-esteem standpoint, because I think a lot of the times when people are speaking and we're feeling confused by what they're saying, I think there's usually this inner thought pattern of like, oh my gosh, I'm so stupid. Once again, I don't understand what anyone is saying. And either I have to sit here and be confused and feel so horrible about me not being able to understand this, or I have to ask them what the heck they're saying, and they're going to realize that I don't know what they're saying, and they're going to realize that I've been confused for the past 5 minutes, and why haven't I asked, and why am I not part of the conversation? And all of a sudden, this little problem of like, I don't understand what they're saying, has blown up into this disastrous, monumental thing. And you're like, well, that's the end of me. There goes my job. And you can see, I mean, I don't know if everyone's brain is as crazy as my brain, and it is quite scary to reveal how crazy my brain is, but I know for me, my brain can go from like, oh, I'm confused, to like, oh, okay, I'm going to get fired now. It's cool. So anyway, I've gotten much better at becoming aware of those thought patterns and not letting that happen. But I think that it can be quite common to feel that way, to feel afraid because we don't know what's going on, and to think like, oh my goodness, there is something wrong with me here. Like, why can't I just follow what is happening? And there's actually a lot to unpack here. I'll try to keep this brief because this is a bonus episode, usually a little bit shorter than the full length episodes, but I think that there are a lot of assumptions that we make when people are talking that we don't even realize that we're making. And one of the biggest things that I have learned in my career, and that I wish I had picked up on and been willing to believe sooner, is that when people are talking, they're not always being clear. And sometimes they don't even know what they're talking about. So if two people are having a conversation and you are feeling confused, there is a high probability that they are misunderstanding each other, whether they think they are or not. Because here's the thing when it comes to speaking and when it comes to communication in a professional setting. If you don't understand what someone is saying, and you are supposed to be there, and you are supposed to be a part of the conversation, it means that a break in communication has happened. So the thing that the person was intending to say got lost somewhere on the way from it becoming something that went from a thought that they had to something they shared out loud and then hitting your brain and translating into a thought for you. So that could normally be a smooth process where they have an idea and then they share it and then you hear it and it makes sense to you. But a miscommunication is when somewhere along that journey from their idea becoming words and entering into your brain, somewhere along that journey, something broke. And I think we always tend to assume that the place in the journey where the thing broke is in our minds. So we don't stop and say, wait, are they expressing this idea clearly? We just jump straight to, oh, I'm an idiot. I should understand this, but I'm an idiot and I don't understand it. And this isn't about playing the blame game. And this isn't about saying, like, are you the dumb one or are they the one that can't communicate? This actually has nothing to do with that at all. But the point that I'm trying to make by bringing in this idea is that when we try to share things at work and when we try to communicate ideas, sometimes the things that we're sharing can be so ambiguous and nuanced and complex and complicated that it's not even about whether you didn't understand it or they didn't communicate it clearly. There's just so much to untangle in what we're working on that it requires both of us. It requires the person explaining it to be very conscious of how they're explaining it. And it requires the person listening to really ask questions and probe where they're not understanding. And so asking questions is part of the process. And being confused doesn't mean that you're stupid. It just means that a communication breakdown has happened. And that can sometimes happen, like I said, because what they're saying isn't totally clear. Or it can happen just because the thing that's being talked about is difficult to talk about clearly. And so it becomes very, very important to ask questions. And if you find yourself falling into this thought pattern of, oh my gosh, like, I don't understand this. That means I'm not smart and I don't want to ask a question because that's going to show people that I'm not smart and that I don't know what they're saying and I don't want them to find that out. If you feel that way, I want to share something with you that I think might really, really help you. And this is something that I've learned throughout my career that has been enormously helpful to me. And I have had the privilege and the joy in my career to get to do a lot of work that goes in front of people who run organizations. So I've gotten to do a lot of work and be in a lot of, you know, very interesting meetings where there are CEOs and CFOs and really incredibly smart people who run companies. And I noticed that they're really, really good at asking questions. And they almost always ask questions when they're confused. And you can tell because as someone is sharing something with them, the second something isn't clear, they'll ask a question. And I've had moments where I've, you know, been sitting in a meeting and saw something being shared to someone very senior up in an organization, someone in the C-suite. And as I heard that person sharing, I remember thinking, I don't understand what they're saying. You know, I remember thinking, I feel really confused by this. And of course, then the thought pattern comes up and it's like, okay, stupid old me. Everyone in this meeting understands what this person is saying, except for me, the dumb one, as usual. And then what will happen so many times is the CEO will ask the thing that I was confused about. They'll say, hey, can we back up? What is this thing here? This doesn't make sense to me. And those moments have just blown my mind. They've blown my mind because when something like that happens, I am confronted, like I'm confronting the faultiness of my own thought patterns. If I continue to believe that I am stupid for not understanding this, I must also believe that the CEO is stupid for asking this question and asking for clarification. And through some of those instances, that has really helped me understand that when we're in a professional setting and things aren't making sense or we're feeling confused, it often has very little to do with whether we're quote unquote smart enough or whether we have what it takes and we're up to snuff to be in that situation. And the interesting thing about this is not only does it have nothing to do with how smart we are, but it's actually in those moments where we're able to detach from that line of thinking and we're able to stop questioning, you know, am I stupid for having this question? Can I ask it? Can I not ask it? When we're able to detach and stop caring if we're smart enough or not, that's when we can reach a whole next level of engagement with our work and engagement with the thing that is being talked about. And with that next level of engagement, we're able to bring more focus and more energy to the table because we're not wasting our focus worrying about ourselves. We're just focused on the problem and trying to solve it and trying to work with our coworkers to get to a good solution. And that really enables us to do incredible work. And so I think there's a little bit of an element here of being able to first recognize that the question probably isn't stupid, but second, to understand that, you know, we need to take ourselves out of the equation and instead of focusing on us, just try to focus on the thing that we're trying to understand. And the truth of the matter is, and this is something that's been really hard for me to internalize, but it really is the truth, is when it comes to communication and it comes to like, am I smart? Am I stupid? Did they say this clearly? Was this clear? Was this not clear? Like, sometimes I just want to know. I want to know, like, did they explain this clearly and I was supposed to understand it? Or was this unclear and it makes sense that I don't understand it? And the truth is, there's no answer to that question. Everything lives in this gray area, right? We all have different ways of communicating. We all have different ways of taking in information. We all have different contexts for the thing that we're talking about. So if you're jumping in on a project that people have been working on for 3 months and then you just join and you're sitting in a meeting and you're totally confused, that has nothing to do with, you know, how smart you are. It's the fact that you just jumped into this new thing. Of course, your brain will tell you should have understood it immediately. But what I'm saying is there's so many variables. There's so many variables when it comes to our professional lives that affect how quickly we can understand or internalize something that someone is saying. And I would argue that there are so many variables that there are too many to ever really answer the question of, am I stupid because I don't understand this? There's no way to answer that. No one's smart, no one's stupid. We're all sharing things from our point of view and doing our best to work together. And I would encourage you to try to get more comfortable asking those stupid questions, because most of the time when you ask those questions about those things that you're confused about, not only do you help yourself become less confused, which is the best feeling ever, it is such a good feeling to go from being in a confused, ambiguous state to knowing, but also you end up helping the other people because you end up clarifying something that could benefit the people around you by being clarified. And sometimes you even help uncover new issues and new things to work on just by asking your questions. So my encouragement to you and my advice to you is, if you find yourself in any kind of situation feeling confused or feeling like you don't know what is going on, I really encourage you to ask your questions. And you can even practice doing it in smaller ways if you struggle to be vocal and you struggle to ask those questions. So for example, if you're in a big meeting and people are talking about things and you don't know what they're talking about, maybe after the meeting is over, find someone who you feel comfortable around and say like, hey, I was confused by that thing. Did you understand what they were saying? And you'll be really surprised what you might learn in asking that. And I think that's a kind of a safe space where you can start to get comfortable just being a part of the conversation, not always having all the answers, sometimes being confused or feeling feelings of ambiguity and uncertainty as you're listening to what people are saying. I really encourage you to do that, because one thing that I can tell you for certain is that having the courage to ask those questions and jumping in and asking those clarifying questions when you are confused, that is a C-suite level skill that I have eyewitnessed myself time and time again. And so it's funny, right? Because you might think that in not asking the questions, the quote unquote stupid questions, in not asking those, you're being more C-suite, because you're projecting, you know, the image of someone who's so smart and who's perfect and who understands everything, right? But the interesting thing is, the true skill, the true real core skill behind all of this is shedding your fears and your worries and your hesitations about, oh my gosh, am I good enough? Am I smart enough? Just letting all of that completely melt away and asking the questions that need to get asked to benefit you and to benefit all of the people around you. So it's the opposite of what you think. You don't get ahead by keeping quiet and making sure that, you know, people have no idea that you're confused. You get ahead by pushing the work forward and helping things get done. And one of the ways that you do that is by asking those questions. And once you get comfortable doing this and jumping in and saying, could you explain that again? Or that part wasn't clear to me. You will feel so freed. You'll feel so freed. Your job will get so much easier, because when you're confused, all you're going to do is ask a question, and it might not bring the answer right away, but it'll get you closer to the answer. It's going to get you one step closer, and that's going to feel really good. So that's my push for you today. So the one thing that I'm asking from you is that next time you're in a situation where you're like, holy cow, I'm confused, even if you can't ask a clarifying question in the moment, even if you forget to do it in the moment, try to go back and retroactively ask someone about that. You don't have to do it right in the moment that it happens. You can do it later. You can do it afterwards. But try to challenge yourself to do that. And then I want you to make note of what happens. I want you to make note and see, does the person start laughing at you and say, huh, you're so dumb, I can't believe you asked that, which obviously that's not going to happen. If that happens, please let me know. But that is really unlikely to happen. It is not going to happen. But make note of how they react, right? And start paying attention to those things, because as you pay attention, those things will actually make you better and better at your job, because you'll start collecting little data points and being like, oh, like when I asked this, it led to a conversation on this, which helped us with this. And that's what growth is all about. So pay attention to the results and let me know. I would love to hear from you. You can reach me on Instagram. I'll do a post about this when the episode comes out. I'll post about asking stupid questions and feeling confused. And I would love to have you comment on the post. Let me know if this is something you relate to. Do you have moments where you're like, WTF, as everyone's saying? And what are those moments like for you? Do you usually ask your question or do you not ask your question? And are you interested in challenging yourself to ask a question? I would love to hear from you, so come join me there. As always, thanks for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed this bonus episode, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye!